Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. I know it's been a while. I think I say this every other month. I know at this point, like, when are you consistent? But this time, I promise I will. If everything goes well, I don't plan on being inconsistent, but it just happens. But from now on, you know, touch wood, everything should go well. So anyways, in today's video, we are going to try a bunch of new makeup, which is actually extremely affordable. I bought the most inexpensive or cheap makeup off of Amazon. I'm very excited, but at the same time, I'm very scared to try this because I don't know how this is going to react with my skin. So praying to God, let's try out some really, really inexpensive. Like inexpensive, it starts from 50 till maximum 250 or 300. So yeah, I'm very excited to try it. Let's get started. Alright, so I have a lot of new makeup, like, you know, you can see I have a lot of it, and I mean, it's of course not from H&M, but I just put it in H&M box. And one thing is I don't have a foundation because I didn't want to risk until that much. I have very acne prone skin and my skin is extremely, extremely sensitive. So I'm just going to do my base and I'll come back for the rest of the products. Foundation looks so odd. I have to, you know, there's going to be a lot of trial and error until I figure out a way to film. I don't know the lighting, I don't know the setup, it's going to take some time. Until then, you know, again, we are back to the trial and error period. I got all these products in January and this is my first week and I finally got to try. I'm getting to try it. Jan has been so bad. Anyways, we are first trying the Kiss Beauty Pro Conceal Pro. This is a 3-in-1 set. So they sent, I mean, they didn't send, I bought them. So we have three things in this. They have a contour stick, a blush, and a color corrector sort of thing. I just have my foundation on. So the first one is this contour and highlight palette. I'm just going to use the lighter shade for like concealing and see how it goes. That's way too light, so I'll have to mix something else. I don't know how this is a contour palette. Look at the shade. That's so light. I mean, maybe like somebody who's extremely fair can like use one of the shades as contour. But other than that, I don't think this is like a contour like palette. This is just like a concealer palette. I'm going to mix the same two shades. I'm mixing this one and this one, the lighter and a little darker shade. I'm going to apply it in the same spot. It's creamy enough. Now just let's see how it blends out and whether it creases or stays in place. I'm just going to take a little bit more. I'm just going on top of it with my foundation brush to tone down that lighter shade. It kind of got way too lighter than what I like. So I'm just going to over it so that it gets toned down and blended into my skin a lot better. So far it's not acting weird, it actually looks fine. I am just going to let that be and I'm going to set that so that it doesn't crease. So for powder we have a compact from Biotic's magic compact skin lightening. I mean, I don't want to try this product now. It says skin lightening and whitening for makeup, bro. I mean, it's not in skincare, how would makeup anyway. This is the compact. I don't think they had any shade, they just had one shade because there's not been like any shade mentioned on this particular thing. So this is how the compact looks. What I'm actually going to do is, because I want to give this concealer a fair, you know, deal, I'm going to use this on the one side and I'm going to use my Laura Mercier on the other side so that I actually know if it's the concealer or the powder, if it's acting weird. So because I know Laura Mercier doesn't like, you know, crease. So on the right side I'm going to set with Laura Mercier and on the left side I'm going to use the Biotic one. So I'm just going to set my under eye for now because I want to use a contour stick from them. So this again is the Kiss Beauty contour stick. This is the kit we saw. So there's a lighter shade on one side and there's like a darker shade on the other side. So I'm going to use the darker shade one and hopefully it is dark enough to contour my face. So I'm just going to it's not that dark, it's very, very like light, but I can work with it, I guess. I apply it a lot more. It's quite like a little, I guess, only one shade darker than my skin, so it's not really showing up on my forehead, though it will be lighter obviously. my forehead is a lot darker than my face. Did you see that it's a lot lighter than my forehead? I don't know, bro. These brands, like, I think they're sleeping. It's 2021 and they just still have one shade of stuff in. It is bad, you know. Maybe if your skin is lighter than mine, it'll, you know, suit you. I am an NC40. For me only, it is, you know, not so suitable. I can't even imagine, like, people deeper than me. I sometimes really wonder how is certain makeup, like, so cheap. Like, I don't know. See, ingredient standpoint, if I do my research, I can do understand. But some of the ingredients are, like, normal common ingredients which are there in, like, other makeup as well. According to me, it makes sense in one to two points, that these brands don't market a lot. I don't see ads of these pages, brands I have right now. I don't see Instagram pages, ads, anything of that sort. Maybe so they don't have, like, the much of marketing. So maybe that could be a reason they can pull down the price point. Or second is the ingredients are very worse, and you know, that's how it is. So my face looks, the contour didn't really do anything to my face. So moving on, we have a blusher kit. This is from Steel Paris. So this is a four blush quadrant, like, palette type of thing. I'm looking at the ingredients, and one thing which is very common is everything has a paraben in it. So parabens are very controversial. It's a whole, like, you know, debate type of thing. And I see, yeah, you know, because these, you know, brands are not into marketing, probably they don't, you know, see the customer point of view and change. Like, these days brands are not using, like, at least the brands who market things are not using parabens because nobody really likes them and nobody wants to use them. So, oh my god, this packaging is actually cute. It feels kind of little plasticky, but you know, for looking on the camera and all, the black and gold looks very pretty. So, oh, this was not what was there on the Amazon picture. Oh, they have a contour shade. Finally, I can contour. I mean, it came with this brush. I mean, come on, like, I'm not going to use this brush. It's not even, can you focus? Hello, I'm not even going to use this brush for anything. It's like literally not even the size of my nose, bro. It's so small. So I'm just going to go in with my normal contour brush to dip into it directly. And I'm going to, okay. It's very, the shade is, okay. At least, you know, I'm glad it's showing up on my skin. The shade is not something I would usually, it looks very beautiful in the pan, but on my face it looks a little muddy and a lot, like, deeper. See, it's a lot darker. Oh my god, actually it did went on really well. The shade is a preference, of course, you know, my skin tone is not suiting, but it did go on well, dude. It looks nice. It's not patchy. It went on very well. Like, I had to go in a little stronger than I normally would, but I mean, I don't mind that if this is going to, you know, look this way. I don't know why I have so many blushes. I have one more blush also. I don't know. I bought that and then I think I didn't realize I have that, and I bought one more thing. So this is the Blue Heaven Cosmetics blush on. So this is a very strong, like, very, very strong pink. So I'm not going to risk it. I'm just going to take a tiny bit first. Okay. See, this part kind of looks muddy because of that contour. I'm going to try to blend it out. This first thing, like, started initially when I put the contour stick only, which I don't really like, but this blush is decent. It smells like something. Some powder I've used in my childhood. I don't remember what it is. It's a very, very common smell. I'm sure every Indian kid knows this smell. I can't remember what. It's an okay type of blush. It is matte, which is at least something. I actually have a blush from Kiss Beauty as well, which was in the set. It says Kiss Beauty Shimmering Bronzing Powder. I mean, how is this a bronzing powder? It looks like a blush, bro. I mean, let me open it. How is this a contour powder? How? This is a blush This is a shimmering blush. It's not a contour. These people, I'll take classes for them so that they'll at least understand the difference between stuff. I mean, they're selling makeup and they don't know this. I'm very disheartened. I'm disheartened? I don't know what I am saying. Blush is rupees 125. I got it for 112. Like, they keep changing discounts. Right now it's at 106. So moving on, next I usually add highlighter, but I don't really have a good highlighter. This will be like way too dark on my skin. So I think I can try this one, but that might look a lot pinkier. I don't have a setting spray, so I'm just going to use my MAC. Added a lot of it. So I'm just going to take this and hopefully it is going to... Okay, not bad. I mean, my highlighter is anyways way more pinkier than this one. So it's not going to even be seen. I think it's that pinky. Actually, that's good, you know. It's good in terms of what I actually expected. I don't know why I expected very meh, like, you know, something very powdery, dusty type. Because the e.l.f. one only was like, initially I was so disappointed. Like, after I scraped it off, it was really good. So I had like very least expectations for this one, but bro, not bad at all. My cheeks look like a glazed donut. My cheeks look so pink. I'm going to wash it off anyways. All right, so far the products did surprise me. Now, next up for brows, I again have a product from Blue Heaven. This is their eyebrow definer. They say it's water resistant. This is just for 65. Like, I got it for 65 rupees and I got the shade gray. So this is how the pencil looks. It's quite like thick. It is not a thin tip. So if you want like thin strokes, probably you won't get with it. But I'm going to try. It's already getting on the bottom where I don't want it. I think it's like a, you know, I'm going to hold the thoughts about this pencil until the end. Now, again, for eyes, I'm very used to using concealer on the eyes before I go in with some eyeshadow. So I'm going back with the same Kiss Beauty concealer. I'm going to carve out my brow and also use that as a base for the eyeshadow. Next, for eyeshadow, my favorite part always, we have Hilary Rhoda. Basically, it's an eyeshadow duo. You have two palettes. One is like a very colorful palette and one is a warm palette. I got them for 347 rupees. They originally retailed for 405 and right now they actually retail for 305 while I'm filming this. The ingredients are pretty basic actually. Nothing looks very harmful according, like, I know most of the ingredients. I just don't know polybutene. Rest other all I know, talc, mica, paraffin, liquidin, like basically mineral, everything, all these things are already always there in products, so I do know. So the first one is this warm toned palette. There are a lot of like that semi shimmery type of shade. There's only 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 mattes. Rest all are shimmers. And none of these things have mirror. Like, I don't expect a mirror, of course, for a, you know, thing which is so affordable. Only this one has mirror and this is rupees 179. This is Steel Paris. So this is the colorful eyeshadow, and colorful eyeshadow actually surprisingly has a lot of mattes. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 mattes, which is amazing because I love some color, and of course we're going to play with color today. I mean, I'm sure this palette is going to be good. It's a safe palette, you know, very neutral colors, and most of them are that shimmery matte type of things. So the formula, I'm hoping, like, would be great, but colors are something which are very difficult to make, so I'm going to try to play with a few really good colors. So I'm going to use a little mix of pink and warm. Like, I don't know what I'm going to do. Let's figure it out while doing. So first I'm going in with this blue. I don't know how much fallout it's going to give, so I'm going to take a little amount and first Okay, not bad for the first time. Just going to further blend the edges of that blue. Actually, that's very decent and it's kind of blending out very well as well. It's not grabbing on to that wet concealer and moving weirdly. The shadow did not apply weird in any parts as well. Okay, moving on, let's go into purple. Now, purple is a very difficult shade. You know, even like luxury products, purple isn't that great. Purple and yellow are always like shades I find very difficult to like really like. So I'm just going to go in with this and add that right in the ending of that blue. I don't know where this look is going to go. I'm just going to try to use all the shades in this palette. I'm going to go in with this like shade. This is more that a little teal blue type of thing, and I'm going to place it between the purple and the blue to blend out. Next, I'm going in with this pink and I'm going to blend out that purple. It's definitely not like super easy to blend them, but if you do make an effort, you can like blend them very well. Next, I'm going to further blend that pink using this yellow or orange. I'm going to take this yellow. I have no hopes for this yellow. I'm going to add that on the outer edge. Yeah, I didn't have a lot of hopes for the yellow, and it did like turn out to be not so great. But I'm just further blending out that pink using yellow, and I'm just going to diffuse it a little bit outwards. Yeah, so the yellow is not as bright as I like it, but if I build it up, you can slowly see that, you know, there is a little bit of yellow shade. I'm just taking the other palette, the number one palette, and I'm going in with this lighter shade, and I'm going to just diffuse that blue and blend it out a little further in the inner corner. Next, I'm just cutting the crease using the same concealer from Kiss Beauty. Next, I'm going in back with the purple and blending out those edges. I wish I had a white shade so that I could add it and finish it, but I'm going to go in with this shade. It's like a very coral, it's not orange, a little darker version of orange. I don't know the names of the colors, I'm very bad at that. This is such a random colorful look. Okay, not bad. What do we think about this look? Is it good? Is it bad? We are just here to try out the shades. The shades, yes, for sure. Shades. We are here to try out the shades. I just want to add a good liner on that, like, you know, that crease so that it looks a lot elevated, because I do like the look. It's not a bad look. It's just that there's like that pop of yellow. I thought, you know, if I add yellow here, it'd look really nice, but the yellow pop is not there. So I have one brand which is extremely affordable. I mentioned about them in one of my videos. It's from Rhythm Cosmetics. It's actually very, very inexpensive. This is not available on Amazon as far as I know, but it's extremely affordable. It's a neon pigment from a brand called Rhythm Cosmetics. You can check on Instagram. So I'm going to use this. I just used the Fix Plus and made it like a eyeliner. See, that was what was missing. I mean, it just amplified the entire look. So for low lash line, I'm going to go in with purple alone, and I'm just going to add that on the outer edge and blend it out. Now we look like a whole rainbow. So next, for lashes, I don't even want to try on these lashes. So are you ready? Are you ready to see these lashes? Look at these lashes. They looked really good on Amazon, okay? I mean, I should have trusted my gut ki, you know, they would not be good. Look, I'll show you how they are on Amazon. This is how it looks on Amazon, and this is what I got. That lunch looked really decent, so I was like, you know, maybe it actually will be good. And first of all, it says Bold and Young Soft Natural Lashes, but here it says MAC. I don't know, it's not even a first copy, it's just a no copy. And I'm definitely not going to wear these right now. These will ruin the look. They're just very, very like plasticky. I'm going to wear some other lash and I'll be right back. All right, lashes are on. Now we are going in with a liner. This is ADS Makeup Color Liner. I forgot to apply liner previously. It's more like, you know, a kajal pencil. I just want to like line in the inner part and do a little bit of foxy eye. So I bought this for 124 rupees, but it is 199 originally. Next for mascara, we again have Hilary Rhoda. This is their ultimate waterproof volume mascara. Again, black and gold, more like not rose gold, like bronzy gold packaging. It looks really nice. This is the wand. Usually when wands are like this, they don't perform well. Alright, almost done. This took so much more time than what I expected. I'm going back with that like neutral tone palette, and I'm going to take this shade and I'm going to pop that in the inner corner. Now, finally, moving on to lips. For lips, I have two different lipsticks from Insight Cosmetics, like two different shades, and one more, again, same different formula. So this lipstick is for 80 rupees and this liquid lipstick is for 75 rupees. This one, the packaging is really good. That's the reason I got this, and the shade is also nice. This is the shade Mauve Magic. Yeah, so that's how it looks, and it doesn't suit this particular look. In this liquid non-transfer lip color, I have Ferocious Pink and Coffee Demand. So I'm going to go in with Ferocious Lip. I'm usually very scared to try inexpensive lip and nail products because I don't know why my skin reacts very instantly the next day. So hopefully nothing happens now. Light charging is going down. Hopefully I'm getting done. So I'll know if this is reacting or not tomorrow. Hopefully this mask does not react. I get like my skin starts peeling in very weird way if like a nail polish or lipstick doesn't suit me. So I can tell only tomorrow if this is going to react or not. I'm just going to even top it off with Coffee Demand. It's a more like a brown shade. So yeah guys, that's it. That is the finished look. Probably this outfit is not suiting the makeup a little bit, but we are here for the makeup and not for the outfit. So I'll just quickly go through each product and I'll tell you what I think about them. So the first product we used was this Kiss Beauty Contour Highlight Palette. It's not really a contour palette, but you know, did conceal my under eye well. It's been more than 2 hours that I started filming. It's almost 2.5 hours now. And so far, the side where I used a lot of Mercier powder is good. It did not crease as much, but compared to the Biotique side, see, my under eye looks pretty good. It's not like exceptional, very, very like beautiful finish, but you can definitely make this work. I would really give this 8 out of 10 for the, especially for the price point. Like literally this with other, you know, two products, this and the shimmery bronzer together is for 300. But if you're somebody who's a lot deeper, then I don't think you'll get, like, maybe this can be like a highlighting shade for your concealer, like under eye, but not really like a proper concealer. So the next product we used is this Biotique Natural Makeup Magic Compact. I don't like it, especially because it says skin whitening and lightening and whatever nonsense. You can just call it a simple compact, you don't have to call it a lightening thing. Anyways, there's only one shade available, I guess, at least on Amazon. When I was searching, there was just one shade of this. Keeping aside the shade, it did crease my concealer a lot more than the Laura Mercier one, so this is a really, you know, big pass for me. The next one we used is this Steel Paris it's called some beauty something else, but on the package it says Steel Paris. So we use the contour shade and the highlighter in this. I mean look at my highlighter glow. It's a very good, decent mascara. It's a lot better than a lot of different drugstore, like high-end mascara as well. Not mascara, what am I talking? I've been filming for too long, I'm very tired. It's a lot better than a high-end mascara. Mascara, no concealer. highlighter as well. Contour, of course, you have to work in like a little bit, but again, you know, it does look good overall. The blush I've not used, but I just swatched it and it's quite pigmented, so I'm hoping it'll be as similar to the contour powder, which you can build it up. But you know, overall, I would definitely recommend this. It's just 170. I basically got it for 179 only, and I think it's a good deal if you're looking for a good affordable option for a blush, contour, highlighter, etc. So the next one we used is this Blue Heaven blush. Initially when I applied it, it was like, whoa, it was too much, but now it kind of toned down. It's a okayish product, not so great, but unless your budget is just like 100 rupees and you need a blush, then you can definitely try this. Next we have this contour stick. This is the Kiss Beauty Pro Define contour stick. This is a waste of money. You don't need this. It did not do anything to me. It did not contour, did not highlight, did not do anything. And like, maybe for somebody who's very very like light skin tone, then you can use this as a contour shade. But other than that, this is a pass for me. I don't really like it. And next, we have the Blue Heaven Eyebrow Definer Water Resistant. This is 65 bucks. So for the price point, it is good. Like, you know, usually for this price point, you get like a, you know, a pencil kind of brow pencil, like, you know, normal real pencil type of brow pencil, which is very very thick and doesn't have a tip. So this is fine for the price point, but it is not that great, and it's definitely not water resistant. Like, even if I swipe it, it's just, you know, going away, and it's not as precise. So this is a pass for me. But if you're just like getting into makeup, or you're somebody who still uses that pencil type of thing, then this would definitely be an upgrade for you. But for me personally, I have a preference of how I like my brow pencil to be, and this one is definitely not like water resistant. Like, if I just touch it and rubber is going to disappear, so it's, you know, a pass for me personally. Then next we went in with eyeshadow. Now these eyeshadows, these two palettes are actually, now I've not tried this one, I just tried one shade, like these two shades, but this one is so good. I'm very very happy that there is a good, affordable, again colorful palette. Other than Nykaa ke palettes I really like, you guys know, you get two 16 colored palettes for rupees 350. And I mean, you can look at my eye, except for that liner, rest everything is this palette, you guys, and it did perform really well. So for me, I'm going to, all, you know, say this already, if something is a biggest hit in this video, then it has to be this eyeshadow palette. I am very very surprised. The yellow is not that great, but rest all the colors, I use the purple, the blue, the orange, like that coral orange, everything looks good. You will definitely need a little time to blend them out really well, but once they're blended, they look really good. I mean, for the price point, I don't really mind blending them so much. Next we have this ADS makeup color eyeliner or kajal. I don't really like this as much. It did like move around a little bit while I was applying as well. So it's 125 rupees. If you pay more, 50 rupees, you get the Lakme Iconic kajal, and that is actually really good kajal. So instead of, you know, buying this one, I would definitely suggest you to buy the Lakme one. It's just a matter of 50 rupees. So I would definitely suggest you to go for Lakme than this, and because I don't like this as much, and that's a better option. I have mascara from Hilary Road. Again, this is a pass for me, mainly because I don't like the wand. Like, it did smear around, like around the lower lash line a lot while I was applying it, and the product didn't go on very easily. Like, I like my mascara would, it had to, like, you know, drip in, scoop in a lot and then apply it. I don't like it, and I would not recommend it. Then next for lips, actually really like both the lipsticks. I'll put in the caption here if my lips reacted to this or not, because I'll know it tomorrow if my lips are actually good or not. But so far, I do really enjoy this. This is the shade Ferocious Pink, and they are decent. Both are from Inside Cosmetics. And yeah, with that, we complete this video successfully. It took me so much time to film this. So yeah guys, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, then make sure to like, share and subscribe to my channel, and follow me on Instagram as well, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.